The Environmental Solutions Initiative here at MIT is MIT's strong commitment towards delivering solutions for climate and the environment. Clearly, the greatest environmental challenge that our species faces is a result of our success. We have built cities, we're now almost 7.5 billion. There are consequences to that, and primarily having to do with emitting an enormous amount of carbon in the atmosphere that's literally changing Earth systems. MIT is comprised of five schools: science, engineering, the management school, the business school, the humanities, arts, and social sciences school, and the School of Architecture and Planning. And the ESI enlists each one of those schools and brings them together in multidisciplinary teams to address environmental challenges. Almost every important environmental challenge is multifaceted, and the only way to really approach solutions is to bring multiple disciplines to that challenge. And that's why we include scientists for knowledge production, engineers for invention, the architects and the planners to be able to understand human settlements and how we would occupy this earth in a sustainable way. And of course, then the humanities and the arts and the social sciences to put all of this in perspective, but we really want to focus in on the solutions.
Climate science and Earth systems is the big picture. What are we doing to our climate, and how can we address that issue?
History has told us that when humans make things, sometimes we have oversights that can lead to undesirable environmental impacts. Because so many different materials and devices are innovated at MIT, it's really the perfect place to try and get ahead of those downstream consequences and prevent them in the first place. If you tally up all the inventions that have come out of MIT, it ends up being something like the eighth largest country in the world in terms of technical economic impact. So you can't really discount how a place like this needs to incorporate environmental objectives.
So the ESI leverages the core capacity at MIT in research, education, and then convening.
A really important strategy for fostering research is to provide small seed grants. To date, we've been able to fund 15 of those projects in a whole range of different topic and field areas, from deep sea mining to environmental health. With convening, what we're trying to do there is to bring people to MIT for events, for workshops, to give them an opportunity to provide input from real-world experience that can then inform all that we do in our research and educational activities. We're really excited about our brand new environment and sustainability minor, because no matter what major a student is in, they will get an integrated perspective on how things actually play out in the real world.
So the class I'm taking right now in the new environmental sustainability minor is called People and the Planet. This class definitely helped highlight a lot of the scientific work that goes on behind the scenes, behind all the big news about environmental governance, especially with climate change and the Paris Agreement, especially since we had a professor who built the model that a lot of policymakers use and refer to when they were trying to make decisions. So knowing exactly how we can go from academia to influencing policy, I think, is definitely one of the goals of the class and the minor in general.
MIT students are incredibly passionate and inventive, and that makes them optimistic. Students and faculty are looking at ways to invent a new world.
I think the unifying features of MIT students are they're hardworking and they want to make a positive impact on the world. I always say that MIT's best natural resource are the people that are in it, and the ESI gives us a way to bring all of those people together.